Students, today I will discuss about convolution theorem related to inverse Laplace transform, also Laplace transform. Okay, the convolution theorem. Convolution, what is convolution? Convolution means, suppose ft and gt are two functions of t. Okay, such type of function, then that we can find Laplace transform of this function, the function of t, these two functions, then their convolution is denoted by this f star g. You can write f star g also. Okay, and this combination is defined as integral f of x g t minus x dx 0 to t by this integral. Convolution of f and g are defined like this. Means this is function of t, this is function of t. So their convolution, that is f star g, is defined as this integral. Okay. This is a definition of convolution. This is resultant. Also, we can say this is resultant of f and g. Faulting also called. Okay, so convolution theorem is, if L inverse fs bar equals to ft and L inverse GS bar equals to GT, then convolution of F, T and GT is given by inverse Laplace transform of fs bar and gs bar, 0 to t f t f of x t minus x dx. Okay. This is our convolution theorem. Means ft function, gt function, such functions, L inverse of this is equal to this, that means Lft equals to fs bar and also Lgt equals to gs bar. Such function, that their Laplace transform can be found. So we can write like this: inverse Laplace transform of this is equals to ft, inverse Laplace transform of this is equals to gt, then inverse Laplace transform of their multiplication, fs bar and gs bar, simple multiplication of two function of s, this fs bar into gs bar, L inverse equals to this is equals to this integral. That is, this is equals to f star g. That is convolution of f and g. This is convolution theorem related to inverse Laplace transform or also related to Laplace transform of two function ft and gt. Okay. So, this theorem can be very very important theorem. Okay. So, this is a statement. This is what? A statement. A statement. A statement of convolution theorem or convolution property. Okay. So, we have to prove it. We have to prove it. This is L inverse, this is equals to this. We have to prove. Okay. Very simple proof. So, we know, and also you are studying about double integration, change of order of integration. So, here two types of double integral, we will get some double integral and we have to only changing the order and then integrate, then we can get like this. So, for proving this, L inverse this is equals to this, that means proof of this theorem, just like a question, solving a question. Okay. So, to prove suppose this is equation 1. To prove the convolution, okay. To prove the convolution property, also called property, convolution property, that is this. We have to show that this means what? Laplace transform of this is equals to this. So we have to show that Laplace transform of this 0 to t fx g t minus x dx. This is equals to fh bar gh bar. F bar into gs bar. Just we have to show that this. Okay. For this, this is function of t. After integration, we will get this integral as a function of t. Suppose that is Laplace transform of phi t. Laplace transform of phi t equals to fs bar gs bar. Okay. Where phi t equals to function of t, phi t equals to 0 to t fx g t minus x dx. Clear? That is, we have to prove this. Now, L of phi t, just like LFT, definition of 0 to infinity e to the power minus st phi t. dt. So this is equals to 0 to infinity e to the power minus st. Phi t means integral of 0 to t phi t fx g t minus x dx here dt. So now we get double integration. So here 0 to infinity, 0 to t is the limit of x, 0 to infinite are the limit of t. So here we can write like this, e to the power minus st fx double integration 0 to t e to the power minus st fx gt minus x. Okay, so this is dx dt. 0 to t is the limit of x and 0 to infinity limit of t. Okay, now we have to change the order of integration. Okay, so for changing the order of integration, you know from previous class, how can we change the order of integration? First of all, you have to, so this is our target, remember it. Okay, what is the process? So identify the region of integration and then changing the strip, we can change the order of integration. Here, for changing the order of integration, we have to draw a diagram just like this. Suppose this is t axis and this is x axis. Clear? This is origin. Now here, if this is t axis, that is t equal to 0 here and up to this. If this is x axis, suppose here we take x in this line t. So x equal to 0 is here and x equal to infinity is this. Okay, so here t equals to 0, that is this, in this line t equals to 0, and t equals to infinite, at infinite distance, at infinite distance here t equals to, here t equals to infinite, t equals to infinite, clear? And 0 to infinite. X equals to 0, here x equals to 0. And x equals to t. X equals to t, that means what? This line. Okay? This is what? X equals to t, and clear? Now this limit comes from where? X equals to t means this limit comes from vertical strip. Vertical strip, because 0 to t variable limit, this is the limit for x, that is comes from vertical strip. So for changing the order of this integral, we have to draw horizontal strip. So take we have to draw horizontal strip P Q. Now from this strip PQ we have to take the limit of, first limit will be for T axis. So T equals to, from here T equals to X. So value, limit of T will be T equal to X to infinity. T equal to x to infinity. New limit. Limits are T equals to x to infinity and x equals to 0 to infinity. X equals to 0 to infinity. So, by changing the order of integration, we get here L phi t equals to limit of t x to infinity. X to infinity. And limit of x 0 to infinity. And here e to the power minus st fx g t minus x. Okay, now solve it. Our target is what? LFT equals to FS bar, GS bar. Okay. So, this is equals to 0 to infinity. Now, here we see that this is integral for T. So, FX can be taken outside. And here, X to infinity, e to the power minus ST, GT minus X, DT. This is inner integral. Now we have to integrate this. For that, take a substitution here, put t minus x equals to u. Here, t minus x equals to u. Here variable is t, so derivative dt equals to du, and also t equals to x, t equals to x limit, t equals to x implies u equals to 0 and t equals to infinity, u equals to infinity. So by putting this substitution, we get 0 to infinity fx, and this integral 0 to infinity u, 0 to infinity u to the power minus s t equals to here t equals to u plus x. U plus x and t minus x equals to u, g u, and dt equals to du, du. ओके डीएक्स, दिस इज सब्स्टिट्यूशन. नाउ जीरो टू इंफिनिटी एफ एक्स फ्रॉम हियर इंटीग्रेशन विद रेस्पेक्ट टू यू, सो ई टू द पावर माइनस एस एक्स कैन बी टेकन आउटसाइड. सो जीरो टू इंफिनिटी e टू द पावर माइनस एस यू जी यू डी यू डी एक्स. सो दिस इज जीरो टू इंफिनिटी e टू द पावर माइनस एस एक्स एफ एक्स एंड जी एस बार dx, this is Laplace transform of g, Laplace transform of gt you can say, where gs bar is equals to Laplace transform of g u or gt you can write gt. We can consider u as a t. So this is equals to gs bar. Now finally we get the result. Okay. How? This is equals to gs bar 0 to infinity e to the power minus sx fx dx. So what? Gs bar fs bar, where fs bar equals to 0 to infinity Laplace transform of what? Laplace transform of f t. Clear? So thus you get the result. Implies L phi t equals to this, implies fs bar, this is equal to this, fs bar gs bar equals to inverse Laplace transform of this is equals to phi t. Phi t is what? 0 to t fx g t minus x dx. Okay? Phi t means this. From beginning, we are supposing this is equals to phi t. So, L inverse fs bar gs bar equals to this. This is convolution of f and g. So this is the convolution theorem or convolution property related to inverse Laplace transform. So very very important theorem. Okay, by using this theorem we can solve many many questions. Take a single simple question. Suppose we have to find Laplace transform of here what? Fs bar gs bar, that is function of s, it is Laplace transform of ft, it is Laplace transform of gt. If suppose we have to find like this, 1 upon s minus 1 plus s minus 2, we want to find this Laplace transform of this. Suppose we want to find Laplace transform of L inverse of this. Here our theorem is what? Convolution theorem. L inverse fs gs equals to integration ft fs gt minus s dx, where lft equals to this, or L inverse this equals to ft, L inverse g is equals to जीटी ये फॉर फाइंडिंग दिस लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म वी कैन सपोज हियर टू फंक्शन व्हाट वन बाय दिस वन बाय दिस दिस इज एफ एस सपोज दिस इज एफ एस दिस इज जीएस यू कैन ऑल्सो सपोज दिस इज एफ एस दिस इज जीएस ओके हियर वन थिंग इज इंपॉर्टेंट हियर एफ स्टार जी इक्वल्स टू दिस By substituting t minus x equals to another variable, suppose u, we can prove that this is also equals to g star f. That means convolution is commutative. Commutative means f star g equals to g star f. We can prove it. We can prove it by taking t minus x equals to u in this integral you can convert it we can get g star f so this commutativity hold for this convolution f star g that is f star g equals to g star f that means if we write f star g equals to this then also we can write this equals to what 0 to t in place of f we can write gx and in place of f we can write ft minus x dx also we can write this both because they are commutative convolution property is commutative so we can write also here g also here f that is this two are equal So, for solving questions, whenever we see that the fs bar, gs bar, L inverse of this, L inverse of this, by seeing their L inverse, what will be easy for integration? For easy integration, we have to take what? Either this or this. It is for convenient, for solving integral. Clear? We take such type of combination where integration will be easy. Okay, this is equals to since L inverse first fs L inverse of 1 upon s plus 1 equals to and L inverse second 1 upon s minus 2 is equals to what? L inverse s this is e to the power minus t. And this is e to the power 2t. Clear? E to the power minus t e to the power 2t. We know. So, to prove, so for solving, because this is fs bar, this is gs bar, l fs bar equals to this, l gs bar equals to this. Therefore, this l fs bar gs bar this is equals to this integral 0 to t l inverse fs bar equals to ft that is e to the power minus x we have to write in terms of x and n to g l inverse gs bar is equals to If this is gs bar, then this is equals to e to the power 2t. E to the power 2t means e to the power 2 in place of t, t minus x. T minus x and dx. Now, we have to solve this integral with respect to x and that will be the answer. So, e to the power here, integral with respect to x. So, e to the power 2t is taken outside. So, 0 to infinity, e to the power minus x, e to the power minus 2x means e to the power minus x dx. Okay. So, this can be solved. But e to the power 2t, e to the power minus x upon minus 1, 0 to t, 0 to t. This is equals to what? E to the power 2t minus e to the power 2t, e to the power minus t minus e to the power 0. So this is equals to what? E to the power e to the power minus x, e to the power minus 2x, e to the power minus 3x, e to the power minus 3x upon minus 3. So 1 upon, this equals to 1 upon minus 1 upon 3. So e to the power minus 3x, minus 3t, e to the power minus 3t, or e to the power 0, equals to minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3, e to the power minus t, minus e to the power 2t. So this is our answer. Okay, so simple, you have to solve this integral. So here 1 by 3 e to the 1 by minus 1 by 3 e to the power 2t e to the power minus t minus. Okay, so finally this is the answer, minus 1 by 3 e to the power minus t minus 2t. You can write here the minus inside side. Okay, so convolution theorem is used for finding inverse Laplace transform easy. Clear? So if L inverse Fs Gs, L inverse Fs equals to this, that is Ft, L inverse Gs equals to this, that is Gt. Now apply this theorem, that means this. In place of Fx, you have to put this. In place of Gt minus x, use this. In place of Tt minus x, then you can solve integral and find the value of inverse Laplace transform. So convolution is used for finding inverse Laplace transform easily. Okay. Now take questions for solving we have to find inverse Laplace transform of s upon s square plus a square square. Okay, value of this integral can be also find by other method, but here by using convolution, we have to find this by convolution property. Convolution property. Okay, by using convolution. Convolution property, using convolution property, you can find inverse Laplace transform. See here, convolution property. What is convolution property? L inverse Fs bar Gs bar equals to 0 to integral Fx Gt minus x dx. That is for finding inverse transform of combination of function, product of two function of S, you can use this integral. This is convolution property, where L inverse Fs bar equals to what? Ft. And L inverse Gs bar equals to Gt. दिस इज कॉन्वोल्यूशन. This is our convolution. So for finding this, we have to find this integral. Well, ft is what? Inverse Laplace transform of this. Well, gt is what? Inverse Laplace transform of this. So here, whenever we get some function that is L inverse of can be two function multiplied. So here we can suppose here. Here, L inverse suppose here square s upon s square plus s square into 1 upon s square plus a square. That is here fs bar means L inverse s upon s square plus a square. Wait. Take s upon s square plus a square first function fs bar and second function 1 upon s square plus a square. So this is equals to what? L inverse of this cos a t. We know that this direct formula going. And second part, what remains? 1 upon s square plus a square. L inverse 1 upon h square plus a square. This is equals to 1 upon a sin a t. This is from by our direct formula. Okay. That is a fs bar, gs bar. Therefore, by convolution, property, we get what? L inverse fs bar gs bar equals to L inverse of this into this s upon s square plus a square into 1 upon s square plus a square. That is this L inverse s upon s square plus a square square, and this is equals to integral 0 to t fx. Fx means what? This is ft. This is gt. So fx means cos ax into gt minus x, that is 1 by a sin a t minus x and dx. Okay. This is equal. Now we have to solve this integral 1 by a 0 to t cos ax sin a t minus ax dx. We have to solve this integral. Clear? Here, remember always the formula sin c plus sin d, sin c minus sin d, cos c minus cos c plus cos d, cos c minus cos d equals to what in trigonometry? Here plus plus and right side as minus minus into. Well, into addition subtraction can be written as a multiplication of this. Also multiplication can be written as a addition or subtraction. Here cos sin, this is cos, this is sin. So we can use formula, what you know, formula as साइन ए सी, देयर इज अ फॉर्मूला इन ट्रिग्नोमेट्री, साइन सी माइनस साइन डी इक्वल्स टू व्हाट, टू कॉस सी प्लस डी बाई टू, साइन सी माइनस डी बाई टू. बाय दिस फॉर्मूला वी हैव टू राइट फॉर फॉर्मूला फॉर मल्टीप्लीकेशन व्हाट, टू कॉस ए साइन बी इक्वल्स टू साइन ए प्लस बी माइनस साइन ए माइनस बी. ओके, बाय दिस फॉर्मूला वी कैन राइट कॉस ए साइन बी इक्वल्स टू वन बाय टू ऑफ दिस. सो हियर कॉस ए साइन बी, ओके, कॉस ए साइन बी इज इक्वल्स टू वन अपॉन टू ए वन अपॉन टू इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ टी व्हाट साइन ए प्लस बी साइन ए बी. सो एक्स प्लस ए टी माइनस एक्स, साइन ए प्लस बी माइनस साइन ए माइनस बी, ए माइनस बी, एक्स माइनस ऑफ दिस ए टी माइनस प्लस एक्स दिस. ओके, सो दिस डीएक्स, क्लियर, यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला नाउ वी कैन इंटीग्रेट इट, सिंपल. ओके, सो आफ्टर इंटीग्रेशन वी कैन गेट वैल्यू एज ए व्हाट, वन अपॉन टू ए, वन अपॉन टू ए इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ दिस. सो फर्स्ट इंटीग्रल 0 टू टी साइन एक्स एक्स कैंसिल ए टी साइन ए टी एक्स एक्स कैंसिल साइन ए टी डीएक्स माइनस 0 टू टी साइन साइन 2ax minus at dx. Clear? Now we have to solve this 1 upon 2a integral of this with respect to x sin at x limit 0 to t minus here with respect to x integration of this, the linear factor. So integration of sine is minus cos, so minus minus plus cos 2ax minus at upon coefficient of x 2a and apply limit zero to t. Okay, now solve it. 1 upon 2a here t minus 0, so t, t sin at, t sin at plus here at place of x you have to write t, so cos 2at minus at cos at cos AD. एट प्लेस ऑफ एक्स 280 माइनस 80 कॉस 80 होल डिवाइडेड बाई 2a माइनस इन प्लेस ऑफ एक्स 0 इन प्लेस ऑफ एक्स 0 माइनस कॉस माइनस 80 अपॉन 2a. So we know that cos is even function, so cos 80 minus cos 80, that is total 0. So 1 upon 2a t sin 80. This is our answer. So L inverse this is equal to this, that is our main requirement, that is what? L inverse s upon s square plus a square equals to this. This is our answer. So convolution can be used for finding inverse Laplace transform of functions, such functions that product of two functions of S. One function Fs, one function Gs. If they are inverse Laplace transform we know, then we can write the inverse Laplace transform of product of there is equals to like this integral. And then you have to solve only integral. So this is our answer. Okay. Take another question, that is L inverse 1 upon s s square plus 4 square. We have to find this value. Questions 1 upon s s square plus 4 square. Okay. Here, very interesting. Suppose we have to find inverse transform of this. Clear? So we can write this as a product. How? 1 by s into 1 by s square plus 2 square square. Inverse transform of this, inverse transform of this. If we know, then we can find inverse transform of this combination by using this also. But its inverse transform you have to find first, that is by using some different methods. But if we combine this, as suppose multiply numerator and denominator by s, so we can write 1 upon s square and here s. Something is that now inverse Laplace transform of this and inverse Laplace transform of this can be find easily. Okay, s upon s square plus 2 square. We have just solved now questions. How? Its inverse Laplace transform. Just previous questions. 1 upon s square plus 2 square for this inverse transform of this, 1 upon s square plus 2 square single and s upon s square plus 2 square this inverse transform. For finding inverse transform of this we can write like this, just previous question. So now we use that value. And 1 by s square, you know, its Laplace transform. Simple. So, here, for finding inverse Laplace transform of this, we can use, so remember this result always, और प्रीवियस क्वेश्चंस, एल इनवर्स ऑफ एस अपॉन एस स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू व्हाट, वन अपॉन टू ए टी साइन ए टी, ओके, सो रिमेंबर दिस। L inverse S upon S square plus A square square is equal to 1 upon 2A T sin A T. Okay, this result you have to remember. We can use direct this result. Okay, for finding this inverse transform by convolution, we can write L inverse of 1 upon this S, S square plus 4 square this is equals to what? L inverse 1 upon S square into S upon S square plus 2 square square. Okay. Now, since just like this L inverse FS bar GS bar, that is FS bar GS bar. Now, since L inverse FS bar this L inverse 1 upon S square is equals to T. This equals to T, na? T. That is what? Ft. And also we know that, right? L inverse S upon S square plus A square square equals to 1 upon 2A T sin A T. We know that this is it. Therefore, L inverse this GS bar equals to, we can write what? 1 upon 2A, A, in place of A, 2, so 2A, 1 by 4, and T, sin 2T means, AT means 2T, sin 2T, this is equals to what? GT, L inverse GS equals to GT, we have to use this convolution for finding inverse Laplace transform of this. This equals to this. So, this integral will be used. Okay. So, here this result you have to remember. Okay. Because if single questions come, then first you have to solve these just like previous questions. And then you can get direct value. L inverse of this. Okay. So, by using convolution property, convolution property we get L inverse FS bar GS bar, that is this FS bar GS bar equals to 0 to T fx g t minus x dx, and this is equals to 0 to t fx means ft means x g t minus x, g t means what? This is g t, so 1 by 4 t means t minus x, gt minus x, so gt equals to this, तो जी टी माइनस एक्स इक्वल टू इंटरसेप्ट ऑफ टी टी माइनस एक्स, सो टी टी माइनस एक्स साइन टू टी माइनस एक्स, ओके। सो नाउ वी हैव टू सॉल्व दिस इंटीग्रल, ओके। बट हियर वन थिंग इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू कैन सॉल्व दिस इंटीग्रल, वी कैन सॉल्व दिस इंटीग्रल, मल्टीप्लाई दिस फर्स्ट ऑफ टी एक्स माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर साइन ऑफ दिस, बट इन दैट केस इंटीग्रल विल लेंथी। सो फॉर suppose because here sine 2t minus x applied this to this, then integral 2 times by parts we have to apply, but if we take this is in place of this first function fs, in place of this we can write also what 0 to t gx f t minus x dx, both are equal because what, since f star g equals to g star f, so we can write either this or this. If we write this, then our integration will be simple. That is, integration can be solved easily, but it is also right, it can be solved also, but this integral will lengthy than this. So here just use this part, okay. So either you have to use this or this, both can be used. This will give shorter the evaluation process, okay. So use this second part, that is, how can you write like this? We can write L inverse fs bar gs bar equals to L inverse gs bar fs bar, you can write this now. So 0 to t what gx first function g, so gx second t to t minus x dx, so use this result, okay. Here gx equals to 1 by or ft equals to t, remember ft equals to t, so we can write 0 to t gx means 1 by 4 x sine 2x, okay, sine 2x, this is gx. Or ft minus x means ft, so t minus x, t minus x dx. It gives some shorter process, so we can suppose this also, okay. So solve it, 1 by 4. There are integral, there will be integral first and second. First integral is 0 to t, 1 by 4 taken outside, x sin 2x into t. T can be taken outside, 0 to t, x 1 by 4 common, x sin 2x into t, t can be taken outside, x sin 2x dx minus x square sin 2x, x square साइन 2x, x स्क्वायर साइन 2x dx, 0 टू t. ओके, सो दिस इज इक्वल टू 1/4 t. इट कैन बी सॉल्व बाय यूजिंग मेथड बाय पार्ट्स. दिस इज फर्स्ट फंक्शन, दिस इज सेकेंड फंक्शन. सो फर्स्ट फंक्शन इज दिस, सेकेंड फंक्शन इज दिस, इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ दिस माइनस एक्स कॉस 2x बाय 2. ओके, 0 टू t. फर्स्ट पार्ट, फर्स्ट फंक्शन इन इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ सेकेंड माइनस कॉस 2x बाय 2 लिमिट, माइनस सेकेंड पार्ट 0 टू t इंटीग्रल डेरिवेटिव ऑफ फर्स्ट पार्ट 1 sin माइनस कॉस 2x बाय 2, दैट इज इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ 0 टू t 1 इंटू माइनस कॉस 2x बाय 2 dx. दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट इंटीग्रल, माइनस 2 टाइम्स इंटीग्रेशन विल बी देयर. Here, this is first part. Second part is this type of integral you can integrate first and then use direct in as a rough work. Suppose, because here we will apply two times by parts. So do it on right side as like this, and you can use direct its value. So here, x square sin 2x, integration of x square sin 2x dx. Two times by parts will require. That is first function, second function. First and second. So equals to what? First function, this. Second function, this. So minus cos 2x by 2. So minus x square cos 2x by 2. First function, minus of integration of derivative of this, that is 2x, and minus of cos 2x by 2 dx. So equals to what? Minus x square cos 2x upon 2. Here minus minus plus, 2 to cancel, integration of x cos 2x dx. So minus x square cos 2x upon 2 here. Also, this is first, this is second. So first function is x cos derivative, integral of cos means sin 2x by 2. So 2 x, so x sin 2x by 2 minus integration of derivative of this 1 and integration of this sin 2x by 2 dx. So finally we get x square cos 2x upon 2 plus x sin 2x upon 2 here. Sin 2x, integration of sin 2x, what? Minus cos 2x by 2. So minus minus plus, cos 2x by 4. So this is our final integral of this. Okay, so use direct this value here, minus x square cos 2x upon 2 plus, you can combine it, cos 2x by 2, also cos 2x by, so just write like now, sin 2x by 2 plus cos 2x by 4, 0 to t. Now, put the limit here. What will be the value? 1 by 4 integration here after applying limit. First, in place of x, there will be t. So, t into t by 2, okay, minus x minus t cos 2t, minus t cos 2t, 1 by 2 is here, minus t cos 2t, minus x is 0, 0, 0, complete 0. So this here, minus minus plus 1 by 2 cos 2t, integration of cos sin, sin 2x by 2 limit 0 to t minus, here apply limit, okay, applying limit, in place of x you have to put t. So first value is in place of x t, so minus t square cos 2t upon 2 plus t sin 2t upon 2 plus cos 2t upon 4 minus one time value at x t, and now at x 0. So here 0 means complete 0, 0 means complete 0, 0 means cos 0, cos 0 means 1, 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 4. Okay, so this is our solution, but you have to write it in short. So finally we can get result as, by calculating this, simplifying, okay, so one time more, 1 by 4 here, minus t square cos 2t by 2, minus t square cos 2t by 2, plus t square cos 2t by 2, cancel. This quantity and this quantity will be cancelled. Okay. Now here 1 by 2, 1 by 2 to 1 by 4 and sin 2t minus 0. So sin 2t. Clear? Now minus this is cancelled. So minus t sin 2t by 2 plus minus cos 2t by 4 plus 1 by 4. Here 1 by 4 t sin 2t, here only sin 2t, here minus cos 2t. So here we can write like this, 1 by 16 taking common, 1 by 4 common. So 1 by 4 common, 1 by 4 common, 1 by 4 common, 1 by 4 common, that is what, plus sin 2t minus 2t sin 2t minus cos cos 2t, this is our answer. Okay. Here something is missing here, because t multiplied by also here, that is, this is t, there will be t also, so t, so final answer is 1 by 16, 1 minus t sin 2t, t sin 2t, minus 2 minus time. So, t sin 2t minus cos 2t. This is our final answer. Okay, this is our final answer. So, L inverse of what? Combination of these two. That means what? S upon S square plus 4 square. So, this was our questions. Okay, S upon 1 by S, 1 by S, okay, L inverse 1 by S, S square plus 4 square means combination, this is equal to this. So, this is our final answer. That means here we see that convolution can be used for finding inverse Laplace transform of combination of two function, where one is fs, one is gs, by using convolution property theorem, integration of its inverse Laplace transform fx and its inverse Laplace transform gx, but in here will be gt minus x dx. By solving this integral you can get result. Remember that this combination can be also taken as gx ft minus x, which will be gives easy process for integration. You can adopt that. Okay? Otherwise, integration will be lengthy. So, this was the process of applying convolution of inverse Laplace transform. Okay? Now, time is for your attendance. So, solve these questions. Apply convolution theorem to evaluate first question is L inverse 1 upon S minus 1 S plus 2. 1 upon S minus 1, S plus 2. Second, L inverse 1 upon S minus 1, S minus 2, S square plus 1. थर्ड एन इनवर्स एस स्क्वायर अपॉन एस स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर एस स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर एस स्क्वायर अपॉन एस स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर एस स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर एंड फोर्थ फाइंड इनवर्स लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ वन अपॉन एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन एस स्क्वायर प्लस नाइन एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन एस स्क्वायर प्लस नाइन एंड फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन एस स्क्वायर प्लस नाइन एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन एस स्क्वायर प्लस फोर एस स्क्वायर प्लस नाइन वन अपॉन ओके वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव वी हैव टू सॉल्व दिस फाइव क्वेश्चंस ऑल आर फॉर फाइंडिंग इनवर्स लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म इनवर्स लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म कैन बी फाइंड बाय वेरियस मेथड्स बट here you have to apply convolution theorem clear so first function you know very simple 1 upon s minus 1 is fs bar 1 upon s plus 2 is gs bar so you can apply direct what is the formula 0 to t fx gt minus x dx you have to solve this integral with respect to x and then put the limit and you can get the result okay but here fx what first function inverse of transform of first function inverse transform of second function is gt in place of t minus x we have to apply and then you have to solve integral similarly here also 1 by s minus 2 is first function 1 by s square plus 1 is second very very important question very very important VVI very very important questions okay s square upon s square plus a square s square plus b square so you can suppose s by s square plus a square s by s square plus b square so first function cos cos you will get cos cos fs bar gs bar So integrate f g both are cos. So you have to apply the integral and find the result. Very very important questions. Similar here 1 upon s square plus 9, 1 upon s square plus 1 and 1 upon s square plus 9. You can apply similar type of questions, but you have to solve it and try to understand whether you have to apply this or g x f t minus x dx because sometimes for easily integration you can revert it in place of f you can also in place take gx such that your integral will easy so by identifying that you have to apply either this or this clear whichever function is fs bar gs bar depends this formula clear so here this function 1 2 3 three parts are there so two times apply convolution first time in this questions because 1 upon s square plus 1 s square plus 9 1 upon s square plus 1 s square plus 9 is present here so that is single function that will be single function whenever you solve this so you use this result for finding this okay so first use this Here one upon this will be gs and one upon s square plus 4 will be fs. So you can find it. This can be solved by using this result. So first find this result and then this result. only apply convolution theorem. So these five questions you have to solve and reply me. Okay.